Hello friends, today we'll learn about subroutine. Subroutine is basically a program written separately from main program to avoid repetitions in main program. Now this concept of subroutine is basically associated with use of stack. Now we know use of stack is divided into two parts. One is use of stack by programmer using this push and pop instruction, and another use of stack is done by microprocessor when microprocessor implements this subroutine with the help of this instruction call and return. We call this subroutine into main program. We implement subroutine into main program with the help of this call instruction. So that program get diverts from main program to subroutine, and again program gets back to main program from subroutine with the help of return instruction. Every subroutine is having its last instruction as return instruction. Now we'll check out how exactly subroutines are implemented in the main program. What exactly is the use of subroutine? Now check out, over here I have written one program. I have initialized the stack pointer. Stack pointer is initialized at memory location 9000H. Usually stack pointer is assigned at the highest memory location possible, because stacks are the memory location that are used for temporary storage of data or temporary storage of memory location. Now in this case, when microprocessor will use the stack, this stack locations will be used for temporary storage of memory, from where microprocessor has to come back from subroutine. Now look, I have written one program over here for flashing of LEDs. I am moving 00H into accumulator, then displaying that contents of accumulator on port address 00H. So if you consider that 8 LEDs are connected on port 00H, the contents of accumulator 00H will be moved down to that port address. All LEDs will be off. Now I am expecting that this LEDs should remain off for certain period of time, and for that I have to write certain instructions over here for creating that delay, so that for that particular period all the LEDs will remain off, the LEDs that are connected on port 00. Suppose I have written certain instruction over here, then I want to turn on all the LEDs. Since I am writing program for flashing of LEDs, I am moving FFH all ones into accumulator, and that contents of accumulator are again moved down to port 00H. All the LEDs connected on port 00 will now turn on, and I am repeating the program, jump onto XXXX, so that off on, this will be done after specific time interval. After all the LEDs turn off, I am writing certain instructions for so that LEDs will remain off for that time period. After turning on all the LEDs, I have to again write certain instructions over here so that LEDs will remain on. And if I am repeating this sequence, then what will happen? LEDs will turn on for a certain duration and LEDs will turn off for a certain duration, and we can observe the flashing LEDs. Now over here, few instructions will be repeated. The instructions that are needed for generating this delay. So rather than writing this instruction twice, over here, I'm needing only this instruction twice only, but there can be certain big program where you may need repeated instructions, or you may need this instruction repeatedly 4 to 5 times. So rather than writing this instruction repeatedly, what we can do, we can write this group of instructions separately from main program, like I have written over here this. MVIC, FFH. DCRC, JNZ to what? Loop, and again what? Return. So this is my delay subroutine that I have written apart from this main program, and this delay subroutine will be called into this main program whenever needed with the help of instruction call. For example, I am writing over here call followed by what? Delay. Now what will happen? Alexa SP, 9000H, initialize stack pointer at 9000H, move